There's strife, there's mode of life. Privatised, atomised, systemised, divided lines. Each for themselves, and the devil take the hindmost. When it takes all, and it's first past the post. Yet more still host, the ghost of a community. The safety in numbers, and the strength in unity. Look out for each other, there's a measure of immunity. Gainst slings and arrows, we all stand in surety. Names, games in garden fences like climate frames. And it's a shame that today won't grow up the same. You can blame Maggie, Thatcher or the Daily Mail. You can blame yourself for not jumping the rails. When it's all too obvious this system's failed. And it's not just houses, it's also their shops. It's a 90 minute morning joint to get to your jobs. The temporary contract, the non-union deal. Your TV, your car and your microwave meal. It's a commodification of your whole damn life. They're paying for profit and you're paying the price. The source of the sickness like plague bearing lice. Yeah, you bleed, they feed, their parasites. Self-interest extends beyond family and friends to the whole of society, and as a process attempts to elevate what's great in the upright ape. Compassion, sacrifice, and the drive to create, cooperate, communicate, and elucidate. Rise above our limitations and challenge our fears. No one ever moved a mountain working alone. Without a social context, you can't develop and grow. Can't work the land, can't form a bond. So drop your ego and give Sisyphus a hand. Collectively, we're so much stronger when we care for the sick. We live much longer. Solidarity speaks straight to the heart, while capitalist competition only tears us apart. Solidarity elevates humanity.